Welcome to Engineering Python. This is the Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will continue to discuss GUI programming using PyQt and Qt Designer. We will create a temperature converter. This converter can convert temperature from Celsius to Fahrenheit and vice versa. We will use the following widgets: QMainWindow, QGroupBox, QSlider, QLabel,and Qline Edit. We will use a GUI development flow I introduced in the previous video to develop this program. Step 1 is to design the interface in Qt Designer. To start Qt Designer, we can type in Designer in the Windows Start menu. For Mac OS, type in Open-A Designer in your terminal to launch Qt Designer. In this new form dialog,you can choose Main Window and click Create. Because I have already created the UI, I'll just open it from my folder. Next, I'll briefly describe what I did when I created this graphic user interface. I clicked the empty space of the Main Window. In the Property Editor, set the Main Window's geometry width to 400, height to 400,Set the window title to Temperature Converter. In the Object Inspector, there was originally a menu bar and a status bar. I just right-clicked and removed them so you don't see them here. We don't need them in this program. In the widget box, I searched for Group Box. Dragged and dropped this widget to the main window. I repeated this process one more time.So we see two group boxes here. I double-clicked and changed their titles to Celsius and Fahrenheit, respectively. I searched for slider in the widget box. Dragged and dropped a vertical slider to the Celsius group box. Changed the object name to vertical slider C. Changed the maximum to 100.Dragged and dropped another vertical slider to the Fahrenheit group box. Changed the object name to vertical slider F. Changed the minimum to 32 and maximum to 212. I searched for line edit in the widget box. Dragged and dropped a line edit to the Celsius group box. Changed the object name to line edit C. Checked the read-only option.Because I don't want the user to edit the numbers. I just use them to show the numbers when we slide the slider. Dragged and dropped another line edit to the Fahrenheit group box. Changed the object name to line edit F. Checked the read-only option. Then I searched for a label in the widget box. Dragged and dropped a label to the Celsius group box.Double-clicked the label and changed the text to degree C. Drag and drop another label to the Fahrenheit group box. Double-clicked the label and changed the text to degree F. Drag and dropped three labels to the main window. Double-clicked the labels and changed the text to little arrows. We use them to show that we can convert between Celsius and Fahrenheit. Let me break out this layout first.Then what I did was selecting the slider, the line edit, and the label in the Celsius group box. By the way, you can select multiple widgets by holding the Control key. I clicked this layout horizontal button. I selected the Celsius group box and clicked this layout in the grid button. Then select the slider, the line edit, and the label in the Fahrenheit group box.Click this layout horizontally button. I select the Fahrenheit group box and click this layout in a grid button. Select the three arrow labels. Click this layout horizontally button. Use Ctrl A to select all the widgets and click this layout vertically button. Click an empty area in the main window and click this layout in a grid button.You can preview this interface by pressing Ctrl-R. try to drag the sliders. Nothing will happen now. We will write code to process the sliding actions later. After we are done, we save the interface as temperature-gui.ui. This is an XML document. Step 2 is to convert the UI file to a Python file using the following command in the command prompt or terminal. PyUIC5-x temperature-gui.ui-o temperature-gui.py. After that, we will get this Python file temperature-gui.py. You can open this Python file and see the content. The entire window is an instance of this UI main window class. You can find all the widgets we added to the interface in this set UI function, like the grid layout, the sliders, the line edits, and the labels. Some of the properties are defined in this retranslate UI function. Do not change anything in this Python file. Step 3 is to code in Python. We need to create a new file named temperature.py. I already did that, so I'll just open my file. In the first line of this file, we need to import everything from temperature GUI. Then we will define the signals function to deal with the signals passed by the widgets. We connect the Celsius slider's value changed signal to a user-defined slider C function. The value will change when we slide the slider. We connect the Fahrenheit slider's value changed signal to a user-defined slider F function. In the slider C function, we will update line edit C's text by setting it to the slider's value. Then we use this formula to convert the Celsius degrees to the Fahrenheit degrees. After that, we set the Fahrenheit slider's value to the updated Fahrenheit degrees. In the slider F function, we do the opposite. Update line edit F's text by setting it to the slider's value. Then we use this formula to convert the Fahrenheit degrees to the Celsius degrees. After that, we set the Celsius slider's value to the updated Celsius degrees. Next, we need to add the three self-defined functions as new attributes in the UI main window class. The rest of the code has been explained in the previous calculator example in this course. I will not repeat them here. Step 4 is to execute the program. We did it in Jupyter Notebook using the run magic. The Celsius and Fahrenheit sliders are synchronized. When we slide one, the other will change also. The line edits will show the corresponding Celsius and Fahrenheit degrees. You can't change these values using the keyboard because these line edits are read-only. Okay, that was how to use PyQt and Qt Designer to create a temperature converter. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.